nuclear energy is back to the front page. The demand for electricity is going to grow in the next years, as governments are targeting zero carbon emissions for 2050. As Tesla CEO Elon Musk says, electricity consumption will double if the world's car fleets are electrified, increasing the need to expand nuclear, solar, geothermal, and wind energy generating sources. While solar and wind are widely accepted as zero carbon sources of energy, nuclear still has a bad reputation, mainly because past nuclear disasters in Chernobyl and Fukushima. However, zero carbon emissions are not achievable without nuclear energy in the mix, as it is the most reliable baseload energy out there. And this brings us to the uranium market and the investment opportunities it provides. The uranium market has been in a long bear market since the Fukushima accident in 2011, and the spot price has fallen in the order of 80% from the highs. The current spot price of $30 does not incentivize new production or even some existing production to come back into the market. We can analyze the market from three perspectives: supply side, demand side, and macro. This is mainly a supply story these days, as supply has seen a historic destruction due to the long bear market we are in, resulting in nearly $0 invested for exploration and development in the past decade. Let's see some of the supply side catalysts. Firstly, it is estimated that supply falls short of 15% of total demand today. That has been exacerbated by the temporary closure of MacArthur River, the biggest mine in the world. Cameco, the biggest producer of the Western world and owner of the mine, has stated that the mine will come back only when the correct market conditions are presented. The biggest producer globally, the Kazakh company Kazatomprom, has also cut their production in the order of 10% annually. Permanent mine closures are happening, mainly Ranger, Cominak, and Olympic Dam, which have been supplying the market for a long time. Temporary mine closures due to COVID-19 have accelerated the supply shortages, mainly the Cameco-owned mine Cigar Lake in Canada, which remains closed for now. Little new supply is coming online in the next years. Only the DASA project is expected to come online until 2025. The demand side is also interesting. The nuclear sector is growing 1-2% annually due to the new reactors coming online, especially in China, Russia, and the Middle East. The planned new reactors for the next decade exceed the reactor closures by a fair amount. Not only that, but some reactors are being handed life extensions, like in France. Growing demand could come with surprises in the upside. As we have discussed, the carbon zero goal of countries can only be achieved with nuclear energy being part of the mix. New technologies are being developed, like small modular reactors or SMRs, which, if successful in their technology, can bring unexpected demand to the market. In the macro perspective, governments are flooding the market with money, and as the dollar sinks, the commodities can benefit from an inflationary environment. This is a sector worth having a look, as nuclear energy is seen as an important piece on the carbon zero goals set for the future.